I like this. I'm going to change this to our green. Red light district. Yeah, hi YouTube. I am going to be talking about this small bad boy, this one here. Sorry, let me get rid of this. Beauty of working with your lights when you can also use your phone to control them. But I think I'm really hungry. Let me grab something to drink first. A smoothie or something. I've been running in the morning for the last couple of weeks, and I'm drinking a lot or eating a lot. I'm wanting to eat in the morning, and that's not usually my thing because I always like to work on an empty stomach, especially in the morning when I wake up. I always want to maybe drink a coffee, then sit on my computer without eating anything. All right. Let's talk about this bad boy. So this is the Aperture Mini, the Aperture Light Dome Mini 2. I've had it for a couple of days now. And when it comes in the box or the bag, it's pretty much sort of like the same Aperture Light Dome, the big one, the 2, but very, very much smaller. Now this, I believe, could be the child, the daughter, or the son of the light dome, the big one. And it comes pretty much with everything that the big one comes with. So you have the 40 degree grid, and then inside you also have the diffuser, this cloth. The only difference is that the Aperture dome comes with two of these. So one is a half stop and the other one I think is a full stop. I'm not really sure, but I think that's what it comes with. And the other thing now, this one comes with, which I haven't actually unpacked or taken out of this bag, it's this. So let me try it actually. I've used it for a few weeks now. I've had it for a while, but I never really talked about it, so I want to talk about it. Now, this one comes with a silver thing, and then it has a gold thing also in it, and it's meant to, if I put this in, so it's meant to change the color of the light, sort of warm it up a bit, and it has a very specular look, feel to it when you look at it. It doesn't look the same as the interior of the dome, but it just looks a bit more specular. So when you read on the Aperture website, it says it's supposed to mimic the beauty dish. If you have used a beauty dish before, this is supposed to mimic the beauty dish. So you can either have like a silver beauty dish or like a gold beauty dish on the inside. The dome comes with, the dome doesn't come with this one, but it comes with another cloth very similar to this in terms of design, in terms of how you hook it up. But then it also comes with this. So this is not as big as the other things. So this is the actual diffuser, the actual dome, sorry. So this is the actual dome, and there is lots of beautiful things towards this. I am missing one more thing, the gel holder. I must have taken it out of the bag. Let me see if I can reference it. Let me see if I can find it. Yeah. So this is the gel bag. This is the gel holder. Very, very similar to the gel in size and everything. Similar to the gel holder that comes with it. With the mummy one. I'll put it this here. So this one comes with lots of good things, I think. I I don't know if there is a negative to having a smaller Lidum, but I know that there is a negative towards having a huge Lidum, which is here right now. So this is the big Lidum that is coming directly onto me. And I don't know if you can see on the sides of the film, there is like, it's too big that it doesn't fit in the frame. Like I have to have it in the frame. So my studio is narrow. It's not very wide. It's narrow, it's very long, but it's very narrow. So it takes up a lot of space. And even if I was using like a 50 millimeter, I'll still probably have a slight bit of the dome in. I'll have to sort of come very, very close to me with a wide angle, but then I don't want to skew the entire room. Yes, let's go back to this thing. Now, I've used this on a few shoots, but I also use it internally here in the studio because of the Mami Dome, which is really, really big. I usually prefer this. It's much lighter, but not too much as the other one. Easy to set up as compared to one of the Godox things that I was using for a couple of years ago. I used to hide from my friends and I always had to put the pins in. It was really, really hard to set up. But this one is really, really easy to set up. And it's very portable when you're going to shoot. So it has these, I don't know if you can see them here. It has these very, very similar to the Mami one. So you just sort of within, okay, let's put a timer on and see how long it will take me to set this thing up while I'm seated. Timer, hey Siri, put timer on. Probably 30 seconds. Okay, let's go. Come on. Yep, I'm done. And I am ready to shoot in less than a minute. I'm already set up. Let me see my timer. Do I still have it? Oh, just went off. Incredible. So I must have done this in about maybe 20 seconds or less than that. So that's the beauty of having this thing. So it's really, really easy. And because of the Bowing mount, all the lights that I have here, I have the SL60, then I have the 100 SL100D, then I have the waistcoat. They're all Bowing mounts. In the future, probably if I buy more lights, if I buy aperture, the COBs, it will still be a Bowing mount. If I buy any other lights, I think most of them are going to be Bowing mount. So it's really, really comes handy. So it's very, very multi-purpose. Even when someone hires it and goes on a shoot with it, they're going to feel really, really good because most of the gear that we have here in Uganda in terms of lights are Bowing mount lights. So yeah, that's the beauty of having Bowing mounts. And other, basically every accessory that I have in terms of diffusers are Bowings. So because that's the only light I have. But yeah, this is the beauty. This is the Aperture Mini. Let me set it up for you with the dome, and then you with a this diffuser, and then you will see exactly how this thing looks. Two minutes. So this is how it looks like when it's ready, and you can just pop your light in here and then you're good to go. So who should have this? I think that because of its price, it's not really expensive. It's about $140, I think, which is expensive, but not too expensive as compared to the others. So about $140, so that's like a small content creator, someone that is working alone. Because of its portability, you want to be able to easily chuck it on your light, have it on your assistant, and then move with it. As compared to the other big one, you can also hold it if you put a light in it. For example, let me show you this. Oopsie. All right, so I've got my waistcoat here, and then so if you're a long shooter, photographer, and you shoot alone, and you don't want something too bulky and too big for you, I think this is good for you. You can hold this and still be able to take a photo. Probably hold it like this onto the side of your subject and be able to click.
Do I have a camera with me? Oh yeah, I do have a camera with me.
So you see, have the camera in. Chop, with this on the side. Very easy. So I think this is a good value for money, and whoever buys it, I think will love it. So yeah, this was sort of like a quick one that I wanted to shoot out. But thank you so much for watching this. If you like it, go ahead and subscribe, and maybe share it with anyone that you think it will be of value. Chris Ultanga, and I'll see you the next one. Bye. Peace out.